and a very good evening to you. You join us during the final stages of this truly titanic struggle between Die Fat Belly Gut Bucket and the English champion Tommy Even Fatter Belly Belcher. And it's all down now to this last leg, and it's Fat Belly on the hockey.
Game on.
So it's Fat Belly to go first. And it's a good start. Double vodka. Single pint. Another double vodka.
100 milligrams.
100 milligrams. That's a good start for Fat Belly. Two doubles and a pint, and that makes him fairly merry. Now, what can Even Fatter Belly do in reply to that? Look at the concentration on his face. It's a double brandy. And another double brandy. Can he make it three doubles on his very first go? He's done it. That's
140 milligrams.
I reckon that makes him, yes, he's inebriated. So it's Fat Belly to go again, and he's not the type to let this early setback upset him.
Fat Belly, you require three triple Bacardis.
So it's three triples. And there's a triple Bacardi. He's fighting back. What a finalist is turning out to be. Another triple Bacardi. Can he make it three triple Bacardis and go into the lead with a score of absolutely plastic? He did it in the semi-finals. Can he do it again? And he's missed the table altogether. He's missed the table.
110 milligrams.
That's just 110. What an unfortunate miss. Still, two triple Bacardis makes him. Now, let's see. Not bad. Fairly pissed. Still a reasonable position at this stage of the game. Now, what can Even Fatter Belly do about this? Still a deep concentration. He knows he's in with a good chance after that mistake by Fat Belly. Oh, that's a bad one. A single pint at this stage doesn't help him. Really needs a triple gin with ice and lemon. He's gonna get. Oh no, he's got a Brunel. His game is absolutely gone to pieces. He's got to pull out all the stops now if he wants to win this title. He's going for a triple scotch. That'll help, that'll keep him in the game. And, oh, would you believe it? It went in, but it's come out again. It's come out again. It's all over.
To you and welcome to Question Time. And with me here tonight, I have a very distinguished panel, first of all, a man widely tipped by many to be a future Prime Minister of England, Lord Carrington.
Good evening.
Next to him, the Liberal MP for for Land's End South, Rudolph B. And to my left, and indeed to everybody's left, the sylph-like figure of Francis Morrell.
Good evening.
And lastly, a man who I'm told is very popular throughout the country, but I personally can't abide him, Clive Jenkins.
Hello.
Could we have the first question, please?
In view of the fact that the Soviet Union has just launched 50,000 megatons of nuclear warheads against Britain...
Yes, yes.
..which will be arriving in approximately 4.5 minutes, what are the panel's views on Britain's future as a world power?
Yes, well, there we have it, a very topical question from Mrs. Johnson there. 50,000 megatons are on their way, and we're all going to die very shortly. Lord Carrington.
Well... Leaving the Holocaust aside for a few minutes.
I'm sorry, I'm afraid we can't do
no,
that.
Now let me finish. Now let me finish. As I've said before, you have to view this kind of thing in global terms. It would be very easy for me to sit here and blame President for everything, and I'm sure that would give you something to talk about on your program. But you know, Great Britain is not an island.
Yes, well, I'm afraid it is, actually, Peter.
And we have to weigh up the pros and cons and get them to balance. And I would say that on balance, the world is about to be devastated by a nuclear...
Holocaust, as you mentioned earlier.
Now, some people might think that's a bad thing. Others might quite like the idea, I don't know. Don't come to me asking for a short answer to that one.
Yes, well, I wish I never had, in fact. Because we haven't got much time, and I'd like to go over to Rudolph B. Now, Rudolph.
Help! Help! We're all going to die!
Yes, well, short and to the point, as usual. Francis Morrell.
Well, I'm amazed. I mean, we're sitting here talking about a nuclear holocaust, casually discussing the destruction of the entire planet, and ignoring the major issue, which is the appalling record of this Conservative government. And the real tragedy here is that 3 million people will die unemployed. And here, I would like to drone on about Tory economic policy insofar as it relates to everything
else I've been saying. Thank you, Francis, relevant as ever. And now, Clive Jenkins, the Holocaust.
Robin. My member...
Yes, thank you very much, Clive.
I will have my say.
Yes, if you must.
At a moment like this, I wonder what Nye Bevan would have done. And I'm pretty sure he would have shat in his pants. The point is that while we are sitting here in this comfortable studio... The average trade unionist is down a coal mine.
Yes, well, I don't know about you, Clive, but that's precisely where I'd like to be right now. Another question. Mrs. Bentos of Cheltenham?
Yes. If the panel only had 30 seconds left to live, who would the panel most like to have sexual intercourse with?
Well, there we are, as I said. Time for a quick one, Francis.